What I have in my hand here is a printout of an article in the science section of the BBC news website about ultra-processed food. And this was printed a couple of days ago, the 23rd of November, 2025. And I thought, oh, wow, news, something interesting, something new about processed food. And so I read it and I thought, well, that doesn't seem to say much we don't already know, but it seems like a positive contribution to the conversation. And then the more I thought about it, the went back and read it again. I thought, hang on a minute, this is not saying what it looks like it's saying. And I actually don't like this article one bit. And this is typical of the type of article you find in legacy media and on news sites that have a science section, and there must be a science editor, and you wonder what they're doing and what their job actually is. So I'm going to break this down for you here because it's a really interesting article in the context of what it is that the media is telling us about nutrition. So welcome to ShapeFixer, welcome to WTF Wednesday. And this article, by the time you've gone through it and thought about it, is a huge WTF. Right, the name, the title, ultra-processed food is a global health threat, experts warn. So you think, well, yeah, I think we all kind of know that. So let's go through it, shall we? Let's see what it actually says, and then let's try and understand what it really says. It starts off, action is needed to reduce ultra-processed food in diets worldwide because of the threat to health. Okay, this is according to international experts, whoever and whatever they are, but okay, yeah, we get that, yes? The way we eat is changing, increasing our risk of a range of chronic diseases, including obesity and depression. Yes, fair enough. Governments need to step up and introduce warnings and higher taxes on ultra-processed food. Yeah, good luck with that. Some scientists say that this review cannot prove that ultra-processed foods are harmful. So, okay, here we go. Here we go. So let's see. They've made a table of foods and classified them as unprocessed, processed, minimally processed, ultra-processed, blah, blah, blah. And it's kind of a bit random. For example, processed, included in processed ingredients is salt. Salt. Salt's not processed anything. Salt's just sodium chloride. You get it out of the sea. I mean, there's nothing processed about salt, and neither is salt a food. So there's a bit of weird stuff here. Salted nuts are processed. Well, nuts are just nuts and salt is just salt. So what, you put them together and now it's somehow processed. That's a bit weird. Anyway, it's some vague kind of attempt. You know, it shows that fruit and veg and eggs and meat are not processed, and ultra processed stuff includes supermarket bread, fizzy drinks. Okay, so, but I think we all know more or less what processed foods mean. Then it talks about we eat too much sugar, fair enough. We eat too many unhealthy fats. I would agree with that, although I think there's a lot of debate about what an unhealthy fat is. The authorities will tell us that saturated fat is unhealthy, but saturated fat is not unhealthy at all. It's absolutely fine. And all the latest research has shown that saturated fat is actually very good for you. And the real unhealthy fats are the seed oils, the processed seed oils. Okay, but anyway, so it's kind of wishy-washying around. The evidence of the impact on health carried out by 43 global experts. That's a lot of people. I'm surprised you got 43 people to agree on anything. And then it says that ultra-processed foods are linked to higher risk of 12 health conditions. Okay. Including, so now here's some examples. Type 2 diabetes, yes. Cardiovascular disease, yes. Kidney disease, yes. Depression, yes. And dying prematurely from any cause. What? What? What is that? That's not a disease. Dying prematurely from any cause. There's some weird stuff in here. Anyway, you keep going, and then it gets to the quotes from experts. The change in what people eat is fueled by powerful global corporations who generate huge profits by prioritizing ultra-processed products, supported by extensive marketing and political lobbying to stop effective public health policies to support healthy eating. Wow, that is a powerful statement, and I would agree with that wholeheartedly. So now it seems that this article is actually getting to the root of it. Compares it to the way that society challenged the tobacco industry. We now need to challenge the food industry. Very good, very strong. And it acknowledges that there's a lack of clinical trials to show that ultra-processed foods actually damage health. Hang on, what? Now we need clinical trials, which you can almost never do with nutrition, because you can't put people in a cage and force feed them certain foods to see who's going to have health problems. So, of course, there's a lack of clinical trials, because you can't do that. Some scientists have commented it is difficult to untangle the effects of ultra-processed food in people's diets from other factors. Oh, so if we're unhealthy, it's not necessarily the processed food. So now we're really diluting the whole thing again, and it just gets worse and worse and worse. Professor Kevin McConway from the Open University, who says that it can't be certain about cause and effect. There is still room for doubt. It is not clear what it is about ultra-processed food that could be causing or contributing to disease. The Food and Drink Federation, oh yeah, well, trust them, actually says ultra-processed foods can form part of a balanced diet. Ultra-processed foods can form part of a balanced diet. And then, as an example of an ultra-processed food, they say, like frozen peas. Frozen peas? Is that your example of an ultra-processed food? I don't know where this is going. This is ridiculous. But I'm going to get to the point in a second here. The UK's Scientific Advisory Committee on Nutrition said earlier this year it is unclear whether these foods are unhealthy due to their processing. And that's how we finish the article. So what's happened here? It's called Ultra-Processed Food is a Global Health Threat, and goes through the process and finishes up saying that we have no idea and we can't prove that ultra-processed foods do any harm at all. So what was the point of this article? Who's going to get anything beneficial from it? And I thought, are they just filling up space, or is there something else going on here? And I can't help myself. I'm very suspicious about this. So I thought, well, if you're going to call it ultra-processed food is a global health threat, it makes it look like it's an article trying to warn us and keep us healthy and convince people to start eating better. Because that's what the headline makes it sound like. And I thought, no, because there are only two types of people who are going to see this. If you don't care and you're eating badly and you're on a lot of medication, you're not even going to read this article. So that's fine. If you do care, then you're going to read it. Because you go, yeah, ultra-processed food, yeah, it's really bad. I'm going to start reading this. And by the end of it, you're going, oh, maybe it's not so bad. Nobody's going to be able to prove that it's so bad. So is this article actually meant to try and weaken our resolve and weaken our acceptance that ultra-processed foods are bad for us and make us think that ultra-processed foods are maybe not so bad? That's what I think it is. The UK's Scientific Advisory Committee on Nutrition saying it's unclear whether these foods are actually unhealthy due to their processing. That's how it finishes off. So although it says ultra-processed food is a global health threat, the That's to draw you into reading it, and by the end trying to convince you that it's not a threat and it's not serious, and ultra-processed foods can form part of a balanced diet, according to this. And this is the kind of appalling nonsense that is printed in legacy media, in mainstream media, on news sites, under the guise posing as some kind of legitimate scientific revelation. And all it is absolute garbage that I think is actually cynically supporting the food companies and the producers of these ultra-processed non-foods that are poisoning us and driving us into worse and worse health and driving us towards more and more medication. So I say WTF about this. And I think if you're going to read science and want to keep up with the science, you absolutely have to get your information from a credible journal, a credible scientific, and even that's not always easy, but certainly not mainstream media and news websites. This is clickbait. It's, am I allowed to say bollocks on YouTube? Maybe. So WTF, you know, like, what are the facts? That's what WTF means. Thank you for your time. Please subscribe to our channel and please stick around. Make sure you see our weekly WTF videos, which come out on a Wednesday. In between, we have lots of other videos. Subscribe to our channel and share this as widely as you can. And thank you very much.